So unfortunately, the reason we crave sugar is because of the reward pathway in the brain called the mesolimbic pathway, where we have a release of dopamine. That's the reward pathway when anything we do that's fun that we shouldn't do, that gets activated. So when we're eating sugar, that's the pathway that's being activated. So every time you stimulate that pathway, you reinforce that pathway. In the same way that abstinence works for alcoholics, that's what you really need to do for sugar addiction. Now, I used to have 5+ sugars in my coffee. I used to, and I see my wife just rolled her eyes. That's because she saw me put more in and she's saying, why are you being so bashful? But for me, I've always struggled with this concept of, okay, go cold turkey and the role of artificial sweeteners as a crutch. And I have a lot of patients come in and they want to argue the point. I get that other people shouldn't have artificial sweeteners, but what about me? It doesn't affect my behaviour. What we know is that if you drink artificially sweetened soft drinks, Diet Coke, etc., then you will be fatter than somebody who just drinks water. Epidemiological, very, very strong association. What's the reason for that? There's no kilojoules in artificially sweetened soft drinks, but it does change your future eating behaviours. It reinforces that cycle. So unfortunately, there is no easy answer. If you're addicted to sweet stuff, suck it up. You can try and use sweeteners as a bridge, but they're less than perfect.